Guys, fight number three on fight week one, fight camp week one. I was just a little bit shocked, guys, and I lost my words because I've just seen Fabio Wardley's moustache. He's grown very quickly since I saw him last night. Of course, Simon Vallely now come accustomed to that moustache. Andy Scott lost his recently as well. Sorry to hear that. But we're here in a fascinating heavyweight matchup. We all love heavyweight boxing. And I love, love, love this fight. The English Heavyweight Championship on the line between Fabio Wardley and Simon Vallely. Here you have two different stories, two different progressions in their career. Fabio Wardley, been brought through in the heavyweight ranks, no serious tests yet, under the tutelage and management of Dillian White. People are talking about him as a domestic heavyweight that can be up there with Dubois and Joyce. And Simon Vallely, who we've seen in plenty of wars on Matchroom shows, even fought Maris Bradis, the world cruiserweight championship champion at short notice. He moved from cruiserweight to heavyweight. Looks good, looks strong. A lot of people fancying an upset in this fight with Simon Vallely. I spoke to Tony Bellew, sparred many rounds with Simon Vallely, said this is going to be a very, very tough fight for Fabio Wardley. But like the fight previously with Dalton Smith against Nathan Bennett, we're going to find out exactly what Fabio Wardley is all about. So Fabio, what are you about? Certainly not that Tash, I think, in future, but no. Looking forward to a big test on Saturday night. And let's be honest, on Saturday, your career gets real.
Yeah, definitely. On Saturday is the big test. Like everyone's been saying, it's the coming out party, the announcement, the real test to kind of get rid of some of them question marks that people have about me and them reservations that maybe it's just all hype or maybe it's just the backing that I have or the build up that maybe I'm not everything everyone's making up to be, but I'm here to prove that I am.
Simon's had some strong words in this build up. He believes he's going to knock you out. We had a great Zoom between the two of you as well. I know he's been sparring very well with Martin Bacola. You see this as a real test and you expect Vallely to bring the heat on Saturday?
Oh yeah, 100%. I expect him to bring it full force. He says this is the best shape he's been in. He's been able with the lockdown and stuff to fully focus on the gym and the work and stuff. So hopefully on Saturday night, I get the best Simon Vallely. And then that will lead me to saying that I got the proper win and I took on a real competitor and I got that win.
Simon, firstly, what do you think of this moustache? Obviously not at your level.
I don't think he's man enough to grow a real one, is he?
I'm just testing it out, but I'm just seeing how you feel about it. No? Don't like it?
No.
Not for it?
Doesn't suit you.
No? All right, I'll shave it off. Don't worry.
Simon, you look in great shape. I know you've done fantastic rounds with Bacola up there and what an opportunity for you. I mean, I remember, you know, when you turned professional, you looked like you might be a major player in the cruiserweight division, but all of a sudden, you look like you might be a player in the heavyweight division, the most lucrative of all. You have to take this chance, right?
Yeah, it's a great chance, great opportunity. I mean, great cheer for it. I've applied myself properly, focused, trained well, trained hard, trained properly, done it all right. Fabio, yeah, he possesses some talent. I'm not going to sit here and say he doesn't, because he does. He's fast, he's athletic. But the best Simon Vallely beats the best Fabio Wardley. We haven't seen the best Simon Vallely. I'm sick going on about it. But, you know, I think you might be expecting the Simon Vallely from the Craig Glover fight, from the Athletic Ball fight, but I can assure you that you won't be able to call on Saturday night. You know, he's had a few white collar fights. He's banged a few German out and he's sparred with some good fighters. You know, he's managed by Dillian White. Wow, you know what I mean? I haven't lost no sleep over him because I know when I'm on my game, this fella doesn't stand a chance. And we can sit here and sit as much as we want. We can talk a load of crap in the press conferences. But when that bell goes, that's when I'll do my talking because all this means nothing at the minute, does it?
Tony Bell, you gave a great analysis on the preview show where I was talking about, you know, Fabio Wardley looks great and all this. And he said, hold on a minute. You don't realise about Simon Vallely's pedigree, you know, the podium squads, obviously the amateurs, the Commonwealth Games, the ABA Championships as well. He says that you may be more skillful than Fabio Wardley as well. A lot of people talking about Fabio's going to move well and you've got to try and walk him down and knock him out. Do you expect the skill levels to come into this as well? Do you feel like you're underrated in that respect?
Yeah, 100%, but I don't mind that. I enjoy that he's underrated me, you know, and Tony Boy, who knows, not many people know, but a lot of people, only a few people know that. When I'm on my game, the amount of talent I possess is much more than that man there. And I've heard a few things, you know, he's going to sit back and box and this, and I have to come forward and I have to get him a dogfight. I don't know where that's coming from. I could easily outbox you for 10 rounds. Box rings on you, honestly. Mm. But all this talk about me having to turn into a dog fight and me after this and that. Listen, if you want to sit in box, I'll sit in box. No problem. I'll jab that face to pieces.
Well, we would rather see you have a tear up, to be honest with you, lads, but you've got to do what you've got to do. But Fabio, are you ready to go to those depths on Saturday night to get the victory? Are you ready for a dogfight? Are you going to box a move? Are you going to mix it up? Are you
he
ready
doesn't
to
know
go?
If he's ready for a dogfight. He doesn't know where he's ready.
Do you think he's got it in him for a dogfight?
We'll see on Saturday where he's got, but he doesn't know. No one knows. He's knocked 8 journeymen out. Wow. He's sparred with some good fighters. Wow. Who hasn't? I wouldn't sit even going about sparring. I'd spar with him. Names and all that. But no one gives a fuck. Sparring. Are we? Let's get real. Let's box. Let's fight Saturday night, town clubs, lights on, me and you in the ring. Bish, bash, bosh.
Let's get that work. I'm ready for it. That's what I'm here for. That's what I'm here to show. That I need a real competitor in front of me, someone who's not going to be scared.
And I hope you're the next best thing to slice bread.
Yeah?
I hope you are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because when it comes, when I hit you in your face and you're asleep on that floor and you're looking up and you're saying it was all hype and it was all hype.
I'm a bother of the time. I'm a bother of the hype. I don't listen to the hype. I'm bothered. I couldn't give two fucks. I hope you are. Best thing to slice bread. I hope you are. Because if you are, I promise you, I can be whatever you are, honestly.
There's nothing in your arsenal that you can beat me with. There's nothing there. You're washed up. Let's be honest.
You came
to heavyweight because you wasn't committed. You couldn't do cruiserweight. You couldn't make the weight anymore. You couldn't be bothered to train. You couldn't bother to put the work in. Yeah? And you came to heavyweight thinking, I'll be a bit lazy with my training and I'll knock a few people out. And now you're here and you're in with a real heavyweight who's going to punch your face in.
Yeah. A real what? Real
heavyweight.
Listen, mate, we can sit here and go back and forth, this and that. But when it comes down to it, you fuck all. You've done a bit of white-collar boxing. You've knocked 8 gentlemen. Wow. There's about another 2,000 professional fighters like you in the country. You've white-collar boxing and knocked 8 gentlemen out. Let's be real. Let's be honest.
We're honest.
Let's be honest.
And I'm here. I'm here to show that a true competitor someone has done all the ABA, someone has done all the GB, I've got my Commonwealth medal. Let me wave it around.
Wow.
And I can still punch you up, even though doing 4 white collars and banging out a few journeymen. I'll still be able to punch you up.
That's why we're here, aren't we? Yeah.
We're here to find out.
That's why we're here.
We're here to find out, aren't we?
Ding, ding, that's why we're here.
Fabio, you want the knockout?
Always, always. That's what I'm here for. That's what heavyweights are about. That's what we're all here for. We're here for the knockout, and that's what I'm going to get.
And you couldn't even, it looks like you couldn't even grow a tash. You haven't got no stubble on you. You look like a big dyke. That's what you look like.
I'm young, I'm pretty, I look nice. That's what you look like.
You look like a big dyke, a big lesbian. That's what you look like. Saturday night, tune in, boom. We'll see what this cunt's about. We'll see what I'm about. Let's get on.
Well, we apologise for any language there, but we are in quarantine. It can do it to you.
Can we have a face off?
We'll definitely have a face off, a distance one. Right. Put your mics down, please, gents.
Back of the room, let's.